Hey everybody, it's me, Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie. On this episode of CD Junkie, I'm going to be talking about legendary Canadian-based singer-songwriter Robert Segarini, also known as Bob Segarini. This great musical legend gave us so many different styles of music throughout his decades-long career. Now, I like to start these videos off by telling you how I got into the band. I was at Licorice Pizza, which is a local record chain store, back in 78, 79, and I'm flipping through the bins, and I'm flipping through the S bin, which is always my favorite section. Miscellaneous S, I always discovered great bands in that section. And I came across this album called Gotta Have Pop. Now, me being a pop kid, power pop, new wave, all this kind of stuff, I just thought, you know what? It's got pop in the title. I'm going to check it out. And I took it home, and it was nothing like I expected. I was hoping to get great power pop, but I got something actually a little bit better. It was such a varied album, and it took in everything from, you know, 60s-influenced pop to calypso. It was just something completely different, and I fell in love with it, and I went forwards and backwards throughout his career, and I'm going to take you on a journey that's going to introduce you to the music of Bob Segarini. We're going to start with the 60s. We're going to go all the way back to the 60s. Now, he was originally from the San Francisco area and was in a few bands. Maybe they put out a single or something, but he wasn't in a band that put out an album until 1968, when he was in a band called The Family Tree, and they put out an album called Miss Butters. This was great sunshine pop, sophisticated pop, Baroque pop. It was something for everybody in here, and it's a truly wonderful album. And there's a song co-written with Harry Nilsson on the album. I think it's the song Butter's Lament, but a lot of the album sounds very influenced by the same influences that Harry Nilsson had. It's very creative, very wonderful, great arrangements, great pop songs, wonderful. But this was their only album. But it is a must-have if you are into 60s pop. There's even some psych in there, just a whole lot of stuff. Well, that band broke up, and he put together a new band that was very, very different. That band was called Roxy, and they put out a self-titled album in 1969. This was more hippy-dippy-ish, you know, had a lot of great songs on it, but, you know, one song would be really gospely, another one would be very country rock. They don't sound like one particular band. It's really varied, very creative, a lot of energy, and it's just really cool rock and roll. It's completely different from The Family Tree, but very engaging and a lot of really cool songs. Now, that band sort of morphed into a new band called The Wackers, and they released an album in 1971. Again, this is sort of more of a focused, I don't want to say CSNY, but there's those types of harmonies. You know, there's less going off the grid and more staying in their lane, but it's, you know, it's rock and roll, it's folk pop, you know, very unique band. In 1972, they released an album called Hot Wax, and this was them getting a little harder, a little edgier, a little bit more creative, a little bit more experimental, but still a blend of pop, hippie music, rock and roll, folk pop, just really nice, you know, country rock. Came out in 1972. That same year, they put out their final album called Shredder. And this, you know, by the title, you think, oh, that's going to be like a hard rock album. No, it's just sort of continuing along those same lines. But it's a really fine album. Always an interesting, creative band that, you know, each time you listen to the album, you get a little bit more out of it. Now, they did a reunion in like 2011, and they released a very limited title called The Long Lost Whack and Roll Album. But I've never seen a copy, so I wouldn't know what that sounds like. But now Bob Segarini went off and formed another band called The Dudes. And The Dudes put out an album called We're No Angels in 1975. Unfortunately, I've never heard the actual album. It's never been released on CD. I never saw it on vinyl back in the day, but there is a CD out that is called All the Young Dudes, All the Old Demos. And this features demos, plus I think songs that were supposed to be off of their second album. This is far more focused. It's a little edgier than The Wackers, but some great stuff on here. And then there's some songs on here like Gotta Have Pop, City Bread, that he would later re-record. And that's a great collection. This CD came out in 1997, but I think those demos were probably around 1975, 76. So The Dudes broke up, and then he came back, and he just called his band Segarini. And they put out their debut album in 1978, and that is called Gotta Have Pop. Now, there was an EP that came out in 1977 on A&M, but that's never been released, although there is a monitor mix available as a bonus track here. But since we're only covering CDs, I'm going to go with Gotta Have Pop. I mean, so many great songs on this. Gotta Have Pop, Hideaway, Afraid of the Ocean, I Don't Want to Lose You. They do a version of Slade's When the Lights Are Out. And this has bonus tracks. Now, some of the bonus tracks were later recordings, like about the time the CD came out, or maybe a few years before that, that he would yet again re-record. But probably my favorite Bob Segarini song is the song called Groucho Marx, which is one of the bonus tracks on here. It is stunningly beautiful. He would re-record that later. There's also a wonderful song on here called Goodbye, which is a tribute to John Lennon and George Harrison. And he would record that later as well. And I'll be telling you about that. Now, Bob Segarini put out a live album called On the Radio. It's a cool collection. It's a live radio performance. And it's really fun. It has him talking between the songs and explaining things. And it's a great way to get to know Bob Segarini. If, in fact, you have never heard him before, I would stick with the studio albums because, you know me, I'm a studio guy. But that is a very, very fine release. 1979, Segarini released the album called Goodbye LA. More of the same great variety of songs. Bob Segarini was not afraid to go from one genre to the other. Sometimes each song will incorporate different genres. This is a great CD, and this has bonus tracks, including a Christmas song. Now, what I want to mention, though, is all three of these CDs were reissued through Bullseye Records, and they're the ones who gave us all those bonus tracks. Fan-friggin-tastic. 1981, he released the album Vox Populi, which is not that great of an album, but it's got some great songs. City Bread is one of my favorite Bob Segarini songs. And the song Voice of the People sounds like it's really Elvis Costello inspired. I still really recommend the album because it's Bob Segarini, but this would not be my choice as your gateway into his career. It's probably the weakest of the Segarini albums, but I'm certainly not dissing him or the album. Now, at that point, he sort of stepped away from the recording career, and he became a very, very respected DJ, music journalist in Canada. Because during his time with the Wackers, he had moved to Canada. They were on tour. He loved Toronto, and he ended up moving there. So he owned dual citizenship. But he spent like the last 40-something years of his life living in Canada. But he did return again in 2002 in a duo called the Anger Brothers. Now, Tame and another great Canadian artist by the name of Greg Godovitz. Now, originally the band was just a cover version band. They would do Beatles songs and stuff. But then they were encouraged to go in the studio, do some originals and a couple covers, and out came the Anger Brothers. And this is where Bob re-recorded the song Goodbye, which was a tribute to John Lennon and George Harrison. And ironically enough, it comes just after their cover version of And Your Bird Can Sing. It's a wonderfully emotional song, fantastic. And that is the Anger Brothers, came out in 2002. In 2003, he was part of a band called Cats and Dogs, which consisted of a few of the members of his Segarini band, plus a female vocalist, and then Bob there as well. I don't think that Bob sang too much on the album, but they did re-record his song, Groucho Marx. And this is another place to find that wonderful song. It is absolutely an incredibly touching song. Each time I posted about the original version found on the Gotta Have Pop CD, you know, he would respond on Facebook saying that he preferred the Cats and Dogs version. But before I introduce you to Bob's music through a medley, I'd like to say that he passed away in July of 2023. I'd been planning to make this Segarini video for probably about 2 years, and when he passed away, it sort of knocked the winds out of my sails. It was only when I moved and I got everything back together again that I said, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make this Segarini video in honor of Bob. So I put together a medley featuring a few tracks from each of the albums that I just talked about. Sit back, relax, give this a listen, and I will see you on the other side.
Waiting around for a knock on the door. Gentlemen call us, beware. Hoping to see other flowers and candy up at me.
Don't know where I'm going, 'cause I haven't made my mind. pray before they take me away. I'll do it all, y'all. I get to do it all.
That's it. That's my little mini history through the career of Robert Bob Segarini. I probably missed a few releases. I know that he was in a duo that were on the Vanishing Point soundtrack, and I know that he's been involved in other projects through the years, but this is what I have in my collection, and I hope that it at least introduces you and gets you excited so you can search out and build up your own Bob Segarini collection. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe. Ring that bell for future notifications. And until the next time, remember me. I'm Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie.